sleeping with your girlfriend. Getting nude and rude in your bed. Same dude that your sister like.
Mickey Avalon, call me Mr. Right.
Who that man in a black sedan with two
Alright, hey, it's Roman from Viper Room TV. Our first episode of 2013. I have Mickey Avalon with me.
What up?
How you doing, buddy? Thanks
good.
So much for coming on.
Thanks
I
for
appreciate
having
it.
Me. Thank you.
All right, so let's talk about your show coming up. March 16th, Saturday.
Yep. You know, Viper Room's always fun. We always have a good show here. Sunset Boulevard, you know? I don't know. I think I'm looking forward.
What have been some of your best memories at the Viper Room?
I don't really usually have too many memories, so it must be good.
The first time I saw you was for the Sunset Strip Music Festival weekend, and I was honestly like blown away. I heard stories, and your show is really awesome. Like, people are moving, there's energy, it's not boring.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I think a lot of bands are a little bit more on the soft side nowadays, and you come in there like full throttle with a freaking party.
Yeah, I mean, we've always kind of been hip to the fact that, like, most rap shows are boring for the most part because there's not a band, you know, and there's like a DJ, so then if you add a band, that doesn't necessarily fix the problem. A lot of times that even makes it worse just because the way the music is, it doesn't always like work good with the band. I mean, some people have pulled it off, but so we've always been aware of that, so I've always had like dancer, you know, not like choreographed dancing, but like more performance art types, just for that reason, just so would it. I mean, because it's like what you like rappers, they'll have like 20 of their boys like on stage. I don't know, I just think it's not really fun. So
I mean, like, generally speaking, I think partying, you embody partying, you know, your shows are, it's a party, but you see less and less of that nowadays. It's like, how do you feel about just people or like music, the music scene right now, just partying? You know what I mean?
I mean, I think, I grew up, the Sunset Strip was a lot different, you know?
Yeah.
It was like heavy metal, and it was kind of the opposite of what you're saying. It's when, you know, it was at all partying,
that,
was it?
Yeah.
And so I appreciate that more. Like, I think with rock and roll, that's really all that it's about. I mean, so I don't understand. I don't know. I'm not into like the emo thing or anything. It's like people whining about their girlfriends cheating on them. Which, like, maybe if they weren't such pussies, their girlfriends wouldn't cheat on them.
So why hip hop? Why not go like in a rock and roll direction when you started off?
I grew up on like blues and country music and stuff when I was a young kid, but the first music I discovered for myself, you know, like as, you know, a preteen, was rap, hip hop. So that just seems to, I don't know how to sing, I don't know how to play any instruments, so that is far, and I mean, and I never thought I'd even be a musician, but that was the only thing that I kind of would do in my head, like for fun, and then it kind of just worked out that way.
So who were your inspirations when you wanted to start?
Well, I never really had a particular wanting to start moment. I think what happened was, and this is, I guess, you know, we're being in the right place at the right time, was since technology had changed for the most part, like Pro Tools and stuff like that, where, like, in the olden days, if you wanted to make music, you'd have to like save up your money and go to a fancy studio and stuff like that. So you can never really say, oh, that was a fluke, I didn't mean to get into that, because that wouldn't be true, because you would have had to, you know, save up just to make a demo. So the fact that people were like making music to their houses, and then my friends would just, like, we would just fuck around. I mean, I guess any influence would just be more like sex rhymes, like Too Short, you know, pretty much Too Short, I guess.
Is this stuff that's, I guess, a little bit more fun than serious?
Yeah, like we were trying to clown around, still like in the genre, you know, like not really clown. I mean, I guess kind of clown it, the whole thing, but it's like say in rap, it's like real braggadocious or something. So we're like, okay, we'll brag, but we'll brag about shit that like probably shouldn't brag about. You know what I mean? Like, like I'm, you know, I'm so cool. I fucked your dad in prison or some shit like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So like, but I mean, it was. I mean, I don't know. I don't really have any like responsibility. Like, I don't feel like I need to be a role model or anything. But that said, I mean, I don't think I talk about all that stuff, but I mean, I think I talk about both sides. I mean, most of the character, all, pretty much all the characters in all my songs die by the end of the song. So.
What song do you think your fans come to see you perform?
I mean, I think obviously they like Jane Fonda and My Dick. I mean, I used to think, you know, like before I made music, because I actually paint. That's kind of my main passion. And you know, you hear about like the Rolling Stones, like not wanting to ever play Satisfaction or something. And I thought, yeah, that must be kind of a trip or a pain in the ass to like play the same songs or that same big song
forever,
every night.
Never.
But it's not true, because it's not really the song. I mean, the song's just kind of a means to what, you know, the audience brings. Like whenever the first note hits, like they go crazy. So the truth is, I don't mind it, and I like, you know, yeah. And not like the show is ever going slow or anything, but I mean, if it was, I would always know, like, as soon as that comes, like, everyone's gonna go. So I would have thought that would have been different, but it's not. It's not a pain at all.
Yeah. All right, talk more about your third album. Like, what's the details? Can you give us any scoops on that?
Well, I'm working with a guy named Mikey Clark from Detroit. He just flew in, and we're kind of just throwing a bunch of stuff at the wall right now and just see what sticks. I'll work with a bunch of other people too. I mean, I think it's like more of the same. I don't think my fans want anything too far from you know, subject matter wise, and I don't really know about anything else to talk about except but musically, I think, you know, same shit too. I don't know. I like sampling stuff. I mean, you can't really, you have to license all that shit. So we sometimes have to just make our own samples, and but the format, you know, just, and really like using like more distorted guitars and stuff like that. I don't know.
So basically, just whatever
bigger and
goes,
better.
Right? Yeah, just let it flow. Okay. So let's talk about what can people expect when they come. People who've never seen a Mickey Avalon show on March 16th.
I mean, I think I always, you know, I always get funny, like, not emailed, but where people talk on the site, you know, that like, oh, I got laid in the bathroom or this or that. So I think people, I have to do it every night for the most part, but I think people, it's like their big night out or something to come to this show. So I think just like a place to let your reservations down or something. I mean, I just hope people have fun, like no judgment or anything. And
yeah.
And this is, you know, I think this will definitely be my last show in LA for a while at least.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, you can never say ever, because I'm not like trying to retire or anything. I just, you know, this is where I grew up. This is like my favorite kind of place. And yeah. I'd rather not end it on a good note, but I'd rather, while I'm working on my next record, I mean, I got a few one-offs, like I got some shit in Canada and stuff, but I mean, here, I think it'd probably be it for a minute. So, I'll probably be playing, I can't promise, but I'll probably be playing songs that aren't on either of my records, just to kind of, that's like the, what's good now is, like before, I just put out my first record, never really played live, but now I can see how songs work.
All right, what do you want? You want to add anything?
Because I'm not a foul chair.
You want to say something to your fans?
Just come out. Yeah, come out. Come out and have a good time. Don't wait till the last night to get tickets, because I'm sure it'll sell out.
Yeah, his last show sold out, so definitely buy him in advance.
Oh, yeah, I haven't even looked at your camera. Right. Yeah, that was good.
Yeah. All right, March 16th, the day before St. Patrick's Day. Do you have anything special planned for the night? Is it St. Patrick's Day weekend?
Well, I'm having my daughter will be out here. She's flying out, and she just like passed her GED and all that stuff. So we're just like looking at art colleges for her and stuff. So I mean, that particular night, you know, I've just probably got to get her home before it's too late. So nothing too exciting.
All right, cool.
But we were gonna have some sort of, I think we were gonna have some sort of after party. Like my friends were trying to figure it out. So yeah, I guess they will be. Well, I mean, I don't know by then.
How do people get invited to the after party?
So, I don't know. Suck the right guy's dick. Not mine. I don't know. I mean, I don't even know where it is. Like, I'm sure that night we'll find out.
All right. So March 16th, Mickey Avalon, live at the Viper Room. Last time in probably quite a while, St. Patrick's Day weekend.
Yeah.
Tickets available at viperroom.com. This is Viper Room TV. I'm Roman. Mickey Avalon. Thank you so much, buddy.
Thank you. All right.
All right, cool, bud. Thank you.